like to thank everybody for showing up. This is awesome. Indulging the time change. I know that it's not to take away from our original when the first tower fell. We bumped it an hour to when the second tower fell. That was the first tower hit. Just to be able to accommodate some of our other agencies. This is a very important day to remember and to let us reflect on why we do what we do and our calling to serve. And with that, to start it off, I'd like to ask Chaplain Doug to come and give the invocation.
Please join me for prayer. Father God, as we gather here today to remember those for Father, we give thanks for their willing men, and their response is that you help each one of us remember the attributes and remember the calling that each responder has in our communities to serve and to protect and to give aid to each other. We thank you, Lord, for the commitment of all those responders who have responded to their community and who serve their community. We ask, Lord, today on this very special day, as we remember the sacrifices that have gone before us, we ask you, Lord, to bless each person and make us aware of your presence. In your son's name we pray. Amen.
Ceremony here with Cowlitz 2. My name is Scott Goldstein, Chief with Cowlitz 2. Joined the organization, joined this great family about 2 months ago. And in that short 2 months, some of the global supply chains have made it so that I'm a little underdressed this morning, but here for pride and here to honor and respect all those that have provided their service. As Chaplain Doug outlined, we come here together today to remember, honor, and pay our respects to the hundreds of responders, nearly 400 responders that perished on that day, Tuesday, September the 11th, 2001. Some in the audience were not yet born that day. Some in the audience were already serving their country in public safety profession as well as military profession. We each join these professions with the goal to serve, to protect, to help anybody, a stranger in the time of need. On that fateful day, responders knew something terrible had happened to the World Trade Center. Event after event told them that this was going to be a significant day, one that they may not survive. One that they may have to provide and give the extreme sacrifice to protect others and to save a life. But everybody starts their day understanding that when they leave home, that may be the call for the day. That may be their calling to help somebody in the time of need, a complete stranger. The men and women that responded that day, who perished, did so while helping others. Sadly, two good friends of my own and my wife were members of FDNY, the fire department in New York City, a gentleman named Ray Downey, a gentleman named Jack Fanning, who perished as well as 341 other members of the fire department city of New York. The over 60 law enforcement members who died that day, and nearly a dozen EMS providers who perished. But let's not forget the over 300 responders that have perished since from occupational disease, borne by their response efforts and their recovery efforts there that day. To see such a large gathering, to see the effort produced here by members of the organization and the community, to have a piece of the World Trade Center on site so that you can always remember and never forget, is a great monument, a great sign, and a great symbolism of our profession, of honor and respect to those who have come before us and served their communities. One thing that I always take a moment to do is to say thank you to the most important people present today, the family members. We come to work to our duty night, to our shift, as public safety providers, because that is our calling and our passion. We can only do that because of the loved ones at home, our support network at home that helps us come to work, their sacrifices. So to all of those at home who help us come to work that are here, joined us today, again, thank you very much for your sacrifices and commitments to help your loved one be a great provider and a responder to this community. To our veterans in the audience, as well as our law enforcement professionals, thank you for your service. Thank you for protecting the country and protecting our community. Right.
Uniform personnel, out in, shoot! Most of history, the life of a firefighter has been closely associated with ringing of a bell. As they began their tour of duty, it was the bell that started their shift. Throughout the day and night, each alarm was sounded by a bell, which called them to duty and to place their lives in jeopardy for the good of their fellow man. And when the call had ended and the alarm was completed, it was the bell that rang three times to signal the end of that call, and the crews returned to quarters. When a firefighter dies, it is the mournful toll of the bell that solemnly announces their passing. To symbolize the devotion that these brave souls have for their duty and community, the transmission signal of three rings of the bell three times was recognized. And now, for all of those who have completed their task, their duties well done, their last alarm, they are going home. Service for today. On behalf of Chief Goldstein, Deputy Chief Huff, we invite you to come and join us in the day room for refreshments and fellowship together. Thank you.